During the Cold War, Russia and its satellite states formed the mighty Eastern Bloc, a powerful force that many feared would take over the world. But if these stories are any indication, the deadliest enemy of Eastern Europeans may be themselves. These are some of the dumbest ways people in Eastern Europe have ever died. Geocaching is an exciting hobby, using GPS to search for packages that have been left in obscure locations around the world, but it takes awareness of your surroundings to play safely, something a group of four in the Czech Republic lacked in 2018. It was a raging rainstorm outside, with floodwaters draining into the underground, but the app pointed the group to an underground tunnel in the Prague sewers where the water was draining. Undeterred, the group descended into the dark, dirty tunnel and were hit by torrential waters. While two were able to get to safety, one young woman was swept into the Vltava River where she was found drowned, and another man was missing in action. They say revenge is a dish best served cold, something this next man should have heeded. In the Russian city of Khabarovsk, drama was brewing. A man had just discovered that his wife was cheating on him, and he went to confront her lover. Angry words were exchanged, and the jilted man issued violent threats. But no one took them seriously. Until the next day, when the angry man returned to the apartment of his wife's lover, he brought bomb-making equipment with him and attempted to rig a bomb to explode when his rival exited. But he wasn't a professional bomb maker, and while he had mastered the explosion, timing was a work in progress. The bomb blew up in his face, ending the love rivalry permanently. When using technology, make sure you understand it, or you just might find yourself sleeping with the fishes. The Terrible River in Kiev, Ukraine is a popular fishing spot, but for those looking to make a living for their catch, they need to find ways to be more efficient. Using a line wasn't doing it for one fisherman, so he hooked up a unique contraption. He connected cables to his home's power supply and dropped the other end to the river. This created a powerful electric shock that killed countless fish and sent them floating to the surface. He reached in to collect his catch and forgot to disconnect the power, hitting himself with a massive electric shock that killed him instantly and probably scared off some cats that smelled the cooked fish. Sometimes in the battle of man versus animals, the animals win one. In Hungary, Christmas has a bloody tradition, parties where people slaughter pigs that will become part of Christmas dinner. Of course, pigs are big animals and surprisingly fast, so it's important to stun them first, if you have the right equipment. At a party in the village of Darvash Pusta, a visiting man from Croatia decided to try his luck with a homemade pig stunner and proceeded to shock himself to death, causing a fatal heart attack. When another man tried to unplug the device, he put himself in the hospital as well. And when the pig's owner saw this horrible scene, he suffered a fatal heart attack. Two deaths, and none of them was the pig. Sometimes just because you can do something doesn't mean you should. It was 2017 when an unknown welder put himself in the history books the worst way. He worked for a highway division in Russia and was working with some decommissioned military equipment. He noticed that the mouth of an artillery howitzer was just wide enough to fit a fire extinguisher in the barrel. Naturally, there was only one thing to do. Not satisfied with the buzzworthy picture, he proceeded to load the cannon with calcium carbide and water, and the fire extinguisher proceeded to explode, sending shrapnel all around the room. The welder was hit by debris and was killed instantly, no doubt saving him from quick termination of another sort. Even if you believe you can do something, maybe you shouldn't test it. In the latter days of the Soviet Union, there was a small cottage industry of mentalists, psychics, and healers who claimed to have supernatural powers. One of the most renowned was E. Frankel, whose specialty was telekinesis. He claimed to be able to stop cars, bikes, and even streetcars in their tracks. There was just one problem with that. All those have brakes, and you don't need psychic powers to stop them, just some good timing on the driver's part. So he decided to try a bigger stunt, stopping an entire train. He stepped onto a train track, raised his hands, and tried to use his psychic powers to stop it in its tracks. The engineer slammed on the brakes and the train did successfully stop, a few feet too late for the unfortunate Mr. Frankel, whose psychic powers had met their match. They say hands-on learning is the best way, but one biology teacher took that too far. Lydia Sakova was a teacher in Sofia, Bulgaria, and she had a dangerous hobby in chemistry. She liked to perform volatile experiments with the help of her husband and friend, and now they had decided to take it to the public square. Bystanders watched as they dashed from their car, ran to a nearby manhole where they started pouring unknown chemicals into the drain. The chemicals were highly flammable and caused the manhole to explode, sending the manhole cover directly into the head of the unfortunate Miss Sokova, decapitating her. Her two partners in crime suffered serious face and eye injuries, but no one's quite sure what possessed them to start pouring chemicals into a sewer. But some chemical experiments are more disastrous than others. Few things are more painful to the young child than the loss of a grandmother, and when young Sergei's grandmother was ill, the Russian boy vowed to unlock the secret of immortality for her. This led him to a bizarre obsession, ingesting small quantities of poison to strengthen his body. He tested toxic mushrooms, arsenic, and cyanide, and even tried to get his friends to join him so they could all be immortal. Despite this, he became a successful university student until the day he pushed it a little too far. After ingesting cyanide, he felt sick and asked for water. When a classmate brought it, he poured more cyanide powder into it and drank the whole thing. He boasted that nothing could kill him, but he soon went into convulsions, then a coma, and then death. Was he a gifted chemist who gave his all for science, or just a nutcase, or both? Heroes don't always get rewarded. Sometimes they just dig a bigger hole. The small town of Karczówka, Poland only had 160 residents and a big old school septic tank to handle the waste of a local hog farm. This was a dangerous, smelly job, and one day the driver who had to empty it was overcome by the intense hydrogen sulfide fumes and passed out right into the tank. Another person jumped in to help him, and they quickly passed out and drowned as well. This would seem to be an indication to wait for help, but the people of Karczówka weren't built that way. One after another, people jumped in to search, and no one came out, except the eighth person who was eventually rescued by emergency workers. In all, the great septic tank disaster of Karczówka claimed a whopping 5% of the town's population. This next pool disaster was one of a very different sort. In Moscow, Yekaterina Dedenko was a fast-rising influencer. She was celebrating her 29th birthday in style in 2020. One of the star attractions for her guests was a sprawling pool, but her guests were starting to complain that it was getting too warm, so she decided to cool it off with a flash by dropping dry ice into the pool, making it colder and adding an impressive blast of smoke. But dry ice is a form of carbon dioxide, and the area wasn't properly ventilated. The people in the area soon started choking and passing out, but by the time emergency workers got there, three of the influencer's guests were dead, including the husband of the host. But it's not the only death caused by social media in Russia. To build your brand as an influencer, you need exciting content, and few things are more exciting than death-defying stunts. For teenage Russian influencer Andrei Rotrovsky, he had become known for taking photos in dangerous situations, like hanging from ledges high above the street. For his latest stunt, Rotrovsky climbed to the top of a 9-floor building attached to a rope. He then planned to take a photo as if he were free-falling from the building. But ropes aren't foolproof, and as the young influencer threw himself off, the tether snapped and he plunged to the ground below, going viral worldwide for a very different reason than he had hoped. Selfies can be a dangerous game, even if they're supposed to be cute and furry. A fisherman in Belarus was busy at his trade when he and his friends got an unexpected visitor, a beaver. The fuzzy rodent was no doubt busy with his hard work building dams, but the fisherman decided he'd like to get a picture with it. As he approached the beaver to snap a photo, the angry critter lunged forward and bit him on the thigh. This was unlucky enough to sever an artery, and his friends tried to stem the blood flow, but the man died before help could arrive. While beavers aren't usually aggressive, authorities did warn people not to disturb the creatures. After all, they regularly bite through trees. Don't make them angry. You wouldn't like them when they're angry. Having a good time is all well and good. Just don't get carried away like this next couple did. A young couple was driving their off-road vehicle when they stopped by a lake, and their passion overcame them. They started having vigorous sex, vigorous enough that it started the vehicle moving while they were in the back seat. It started rolling into the lake, and by the time the couple realized what had happened, the water had jammed the locks, and they were unable to escape. The vehicle was eventually fished out of the water with their bodies inside, and many blamed the vehicle's design for trapping them. But authorities suggested future tragedies could be avoided by having sex in slightly safer locations. How big a disaster could some reckless soldiers cause? A town in Ukraine found out. Working at a military base is hard work, especially when you're working with heavy boxes of ammunition, so it's not a surprise a group of soldiers in 2004 needed a smoke break. They just made one fatal mistake, flicking their cigarette butts away. They didn't notice the butts started a small fire, which grew, until it kicked off a chain reaction of explosions that not just engulfed the base, but the nearby town as well. Debris was tossed as much as 25 miles away, buildings within a 2-mile radius were destroyed, and thousands of people had to be evacuated. Only one of the soldiers at the base died from explosions, but the others faced serious criminal charges. That was a very costly smoke break. Snack breaks are usually safer, but not always. The Kiev Polytechnic Institute in Ukraine is usually a place of safe experiments, but one student had an unusual habit. He chewed gum while working, but he liked to dip it in citric acid crystals to give it a sour kick. He was working on a chemical experiment one night when he apparently got distracted, gave his gum the usual dip and put it in his mouth, and proceeded to blow his head off. It took a while for emergency workers to figure out what had happened, until they found another dish of powder. Apparently, he had gotten his citric acid dip confused with the chemicals he was experimenting with, and this created a much more explosive taste sensation. But no one tempted fate more than this soldier. Alexander Chichik's friends were surprised to receive a message from him on the Russian social media service VK. It looked like him holding a grenade. But there was one disturbing thing about it, the pin appeared to be pulled out. His friends panicked, warning him, but it was too late, as the grenade exploded and killed the Russian man instantly. What possessed him to try to take a live grenade selfie? Authorities believe he may have thought the grenade would only explode when someone actually threw it, because that's how it's always shown in the movies. Hey, it's not called Smartest Ways to Die. Check out Dumb Ways to Die US edition to see America's side of the Cold War rivalry, or watch this video instead.